Happy Labor Day. Got everything set up for both of the cameras. We're gonna get back to the spot painting, which I was left off on a couple weeks ago. Been working with the National Loon Center. This is my 50-50 turpentine medium I'm mixing up. Grumbacher. And this is my oil painting medium number one, which is, gives you a matte finish. Life-size loons, the one with the two chicks, and the one with that I won in the world with in 2011, are going into the National Loon Center as a family of loons. It's very exciting. So I've been busy making that happen. And met some wonderful people along the way. So I'm going to continue on to this scapular group, and then I'll go over the second pass on the small spots on the side pockets. Since this is dry, I'll be able to, once I get on the second or third row, the third or fourth row, I'll be able to paint from this direction. But for right now, I need to approach it this direction, and there's no real good view for anybody except maybe me, which is important. Ago, before COVID, I got an invitation from Carol Henderson, my friend at the Minnesota Department of Natural Resources, and he wanted me to begin get involved with the planning and fruition of the National Loon Center to be built in Cross Lake, Minnesota. So I went up north to Baxter and had a meeting, a nice lunch, met some of the interns that were working with Carol. And I brought one of my Loon books and expressed, you know, my interest in becoming involved. Some good ideas, and we talked about a carving sculpture, a Loon sculpture. And I just happened to have a couple of them. And then COVID hit. We didn't get to progress in the planning. So it was supposed to open in April of 2022 and was delayed due to the pandemic, but everything's in place for it to open in 2024. So I went up and met with John Mulbeck, who is the executive director, and coincidentally, Jim Anderson, who I had communicated with for the last year and a half, also was there, and it was decided that my loons would go on display at their temporary location, which is called The Nest, and it's in Town Square in Cross Lake. So currently having a glass display case created by River City Glass and Wayne Gajkowski, owner of River City Glass, excuse me, is the recipient of this loon. My mother used to work for River City Glass for over 30 years, and they really treated her well and enabled her to be able to work until her 80s. And this loon, which is a 30-year loon, is appropriate. Because it was started about when Mom began working for Wayne. Was Creative Mirror and Glass. They went through some restructuring and now River City Glass, and they're creating the display case that will protect my loon family. From being touched the elements. So I'm very excited about that. Careful not to stick my pinky into those spots I just painted. This brush is getting dried out. To wait. clean. So that it won't splay. When you familiarize yourself with the consistency that works for you, you'll start mixing it up and making your little puddles without questioning if it's correct, because, you know, practice makes perfect. And you're getting to know your own painting techniques as you paint. And everybody's is different. Yours is not gonna be the same as mine exactly. You can start out trying what it is that another carver artist does, but inevitably it's gonna become yours with your own style. So don't stress out if you can't make yours look exactly like mine. Nobody can. This is my style. I hope to be as close to God's style in my replication of his works, but yours will be different from mine. When I stop chasing the idea, the notion that I wanted to do it just like so-and-so because they were so good at it, or are so good at it, I was disappointed all the time because I wasn't doing it just like them. Mother is also an artist. Said to me, "When are you going to embrace your style, Laurie?" Stop chasing somebody else's. And that statement, it was like a wow moment for me, because that's what I was doing. Give yourself credit for your own style. Let's see if I can stay in focus. It's a hard angle to be at. You know, while you're watching this video on YouTube, do me a favor and give me a thumbs up. It makes a big difference. It actually lets me know you like it. If you don't, then give me the thumbs down. Tell me what's wrong, but, well, there are times when I think, boy, it would be so much easier for me to just not video what I'm doing. Not have to set everything up. Not have to be careful about every move I make. And to ensure the viewer can see what I'm doing, improving my methods as I go. Well, if you guys don't let me know in any way, I know you're watching. Won't have that many views for... Doesn't say who you are if you say you like a video, you know. It can be discouraging to not hear from you guys. So I'm just saying. And that doesn't even count the video production that goes on after. Which is actually twice as difficult with two cameras. Two videos. One time I went up to Bayport, Wisconsin, and was able to sail the Apostle Islands up there. Pretty cool. And somewhere along the way, I misplaced my brush, or I didn't bring it. I had my paint. So, I fashioned a feather I found on the beach as my paintbrush and painted a few ACEO cards of loons and the beautiful scenery. I even still have the feather in my watercolor paint pencil box. Pretty good. those ACE old cards sold on eBay quite some time ago. When I sat on the sailboat floating in Lake Superior, watching loons and mergansers, it was pretty fun. Alexis, my daughter, was with. It was the 4th of July weekend. It's funny because, you know, Jeff watches me paint sometimes, or he watches the video, and he thinks I'm doing this very fast, and perhaps I am, and part of the reason I can do that is because I'm familiar with the first pass, and I've done it in the same fashion when I'm doing my second pass. If it was me trying to do somebody else's spots the second time around, God, it wouldn't be so hard because I'm trying to copy them. And here we are back at copying other people's work. I've always wondered why people want to copy people's work. Like, you know, in the style of, what about your style? Why do you want to carve something in the style of somebody else? Never understood. I mean, if you can carve it in the style of someone else, you can certainly carve it in your own style, would be my thought. I'm getting a little more outspoken in my old age. Eventually, you're going to have even coverage on all of these. Third coat, third pass, usually takes care of uneven coverage. That it has to be, you know, perfect on the second pass. perfectly covered. There's always going to be a little bit of difference in the spot from one side to the next. You can see my little foam things here. They protect my pieces from hitting the legs on the tripod. Now, right now, I'd like to stop and clean up this a little bit, but the paint is flowing so perfectly off of this brush. I know I still have time if I just finish off this load of paint in this brush, because it's coming off so perfectly, to come back and clean that up. So I'll do that as soon as I run out of paint here. Very difficult to paint just a wisp of white for a spot that's lying beneath. If you come back and clean up like I'm doing right now, keep looking over to make sure I'm in view. My brush is ready to be cleaned again. And I'm going to clean up this little bit of overpaint I did. On the second pass, you're cleaning up the the first pass and adjusting the spots to be the right shape and placement. So by the time you come back for this, the third pass, everything's looking really nice. When I do the rest of these spots, I'll have to switch over to a smaller sable. That's the next plan. Thank you. first. It's important to remember to use the exact same brush. When you're doing these spots, don't switch over to another one and wonder why it's so difficult to paint a second pass. That's pretty good. As I said, I'm just going to switch over to a this is a number one Raphael, one of my older ones with the round with the point worn down. For the very small spots. And this is a numbers, this is an odd, a zero. Again, it's a Kolinsky sable round, same as a Raphael. Going to continue on to these wing feather spots. So in your second pass, like I'm doing now on these smaller spots, gives you a chance to adjust shape, size, and a little bit of the location. And where they would show, I'll be back to, put in a quills. After my third pass.
Thank you.